Hey guys, Paul here with Diode Dynamics, coming to you with another comparison. This time we're looking at 2-inch LED pods. We've got the big three on the market here. We've got the Rigid SRM, the Baja Designs S2, and finally the Diode Dynamics SSC2, the newest one in the group. Now, there's a lot of different optic patterns and colors with all of these from the three different brands. We're going to compare the output thanks to measurements from our light tunnel and Goniometer. That's a laboratory test, and you can find more information about it in a video linked below. If you want to see the output, just skip to the end of this video where we go through the output of every single color and optic available here. That way you can really choose the best beam pattern for your setup. But before we do that, we're going to take a look at comparing some of the major features of these lights. Now, as you can see, they're all very similar in appearance. That 2-inch style is basically two LEDs about 2 by 1 inches. But they are different in the size. The Rigid one tapers to the front a bit, and it's not very deep. The Baja one is also similar. It's more rectangular, more boxy, but it's not very deep either. The Diode Dynamics is actually the largest one out of the group. You can really tell if you hold them next to each other. And it is the deepest. And you'll see why. This runs at the highest power as well. But this might be important if you're trying to mount it in a specific location, up on a roof rack, under a bumper. You want to make sure that you have enough room, so check the dimensional drawings on each one of the manufacturer's websites before you buy anything. Now, you might notice this fourth Rigid one is much bigger as well. That's because this is actually the OEM Toyota TRD fog light. It's in the same series, but it also runs at a higher power level, so sure enough, the heat sink's much bigger as well. You can find these on eBay or from a Toyota dealer, but they are a little hard to mount for universal applications because they don't have a standard mounting setup. Also, you might notice that the wiring is different between the three as well. The Rigid lamp has a Deutsch DT style connector on a wire lead here. The Baja is also on a wire lead, but it's got a proprietary 2-pin connector. It does come with a wiring kit. And the Diode Dynamics does not have a wire lead. Instead, a 4-pin style Deutsch DT plugs directly into the back. The mounting is all pretty similar for these, except for that OEM one. They just have little pegs here for a very small bracket to mount them up. So no real differences there. And they're all complete aluminum enclosures, either CNC'd or cast. They should be really durable no matter which brand you go with. So the last thing is really the function in the lenses. So when we talk lenses, the Rigid, you're really not supposed to service these. You don't swap out the lenses. They are available in a lot of different optics though. The Baja Designs, you can swap these out. It's called their U-service, where you just remove the four screws and you can change out that outer lens. You can change the color or the beam pattern that way. Diode Dynamics, you can remove the four screws on the back and swap the lens out in the same way. When you swap that lens out, it's actually the entire optical lens. That's the proprietary TIR, which is custom designed for this lamp to really capture and focus as much light as possible. Now, these are available in a lot of different beam patterns, and we tested as many as we could. Diode Dynamics has 5, Baja Designs has 4, and Rigid has quite a few more. Now, when it comes to the output, all of these have a main white or amber output pattern. Diode Dynamics has an extra backlight as well. These don't have a backlight or any accent light. The Diode Dynamics, though, has that 4-pin connector on the back here, and that's because it's got a backlight feature. So you can see when we light it up, this is actually a white light, but it's got an amber backlight on it. It's a really great look because it illuminates the entire TIR lens. And when we switch it to the main beam power, the backlight will turn off and you'll get the main output. This is available in white, amber, red, and blue. However, for the yellow lens, it's only available in amber because the lens is yellow. This is a great way to add a little bit of extra style and an extra function to your setup, especially with that red backlight on a rear bumper setup or something like that. It's just a great extra feature that really gives you a lot for the price. Now let's take a look at how those main beam patterns compare. First up is the Rigid SRM, with the spot pattern being about 20 by 20 degrees. It shines with 30,300 candela. That's quite a bit of intensity. At $120 each, it's a pretty good value as well. Next up is the Baja in the Sport power level. The spotlight on this is also about 20 by 20 degrees, but a little bit lower intensity at 24,000 candela. It runs at 11 watts of power, and it's $110 each. Going up to the pro power level, the spot is actually almost the same. It's a little bit bigger at 22 degrees, but the intensity is 23,000 candela. And this is because when we first started it up, it ran at about 22 watts. But after only a couple minutes, the power level dropped to only 13 watts. When we measure LEDs, it's really important to get the stable operating temperature to get a realistic expectation of the output after the thing gets as hot as it's gonna be. The Baja S2 Pro gets so hot that the power level really decreases after a couple minutes, which means there's not a huge difference between the Sport and the Pro power level. Next, taking a look at the Diode SSC2. First, the Sport power level spot is a really tight 8-degree pattern thanks to those TIR optics, and also really high intensity, 91,000 candela with just 8 watts of power, and at only $70 with the backlight feature, that's a great value. Stepping up to the Pro level, we have a slightly bigger pattern at 12 degrees, but the intensity increases to 97,000 candela as well. The difference here is that it runs at 26 watts of power with stable operation. That's much higher power than anything else on the table. It's a really powerful lamp for this size. Now we're gonna keep going through the white output just so you can see a comparison. The yellow output is about the same, it's just about 10% lower for all these lamps. So we'll show that data at the end, but we're gonna keep going through the white output power for now. That brings us to the SAE fog pattern. Now, the only ones offered in the fog are that rigid lamp, which is actually a Toyota OEM product. That's the one with that bigger heatsink, and it does run with a higher power level. As a result, it's got pretty nice output with 64 degree wide pattern that's 10 degrees tall and 9,300 candela. That's a really great performing fog light, especially for this size, but it does come at a cost. These are $450 to $500 online. The Diode is also available in a fog pattern in both Sport and Pro power levels. The Sport is 72 degrees wide by 8 degrees tall and 5,000 candela. The Pro is 80 degrees wide by 10 degrees tall, again, just a little bit bigger, with 8,500 candela. Next up, we've got the driving beam pattern. Now, this is a little bit of a confusing term because there is an SAE or DOT driving light, which is meant as an extra high beam. This is a regulated pattern which has to meet certain output. But some manufacturers also refer to driving as just a general pattern. First, the rigid SRM driving has a 40 by 20 degree beam pattern at 8,000 candela. This is great for just some extra light. The Baja S2 Sport in the wide has a 55 degree wide by 15 degree tall pattern, definitely wider, but still great for general driving use, and is at 5,300 candela. The S2 Pro comes in with the same beam pattern at slightly higher output, 5,900 candela. Next, we have the Diode driving lights, which are SAE compliant patterns. First, the Sport is a 16 by 10 degree pattern at 37,500 candela. Again, this is much more focused and much higher intensity, and that's because it's intended to be used as an actual driving light. Same thing goes for the SSC2 Pro at 18 by 15 degrees and 59,000 candela. Next, we've got our flood patterns. These are great for lighting up a campsite, especially since these are so easy to mount up on a roof rack or the side of a trailer. First up, we've got the rigid SRM flood, which is a 40 by 35 degree spread, really nice full spread at 2,300 candela. Next up, we've got the Baja S2 in the flood pattern. In both Sport and Pro power levels, these are gonna spread light in a 60 by 60 degree pattern, and they'll both be about the same amount of output at 1,070 candela. Finally, we've got the SSC2. In the Sport flood, we've got a 90 by 80 degree pattern, just a huge spread of light, but it's only 375 candela, really intended to fill a huge space with only a little bit of light. The Pro does step it up to 100 by 90 degree spread and 700 candela, about double the light from the Sport. Now the last beam pattern to look at is the combo pattern. Rigid doesn't offer any combo patterns, but Baja offers it with their wide cornering and spot, and Diode Dynamics offers it with a flood as well as a wide driving. This results in pretty useful beam patterns depending on what you want to do. The Baja S2 Sport in the combo pattern is 50 degrees wide by 18 degrees tall and 14,500 candela. Stepping up to the Pro, we have a 55 by 20 degree pattern and 14,200 candela. So again, slightly larger, but after that stabilization period, about the same output. The Diode Dynamics Sport combo comes in at 20 degrees wide by 12 tall, much tighter pattern, and 16,000 candela. With the Pro level output, we've got 40 degrees wide by 20 tall and 27,000 candela. Again, that's the white data. For the yellow output, not all these lights are available in yellow or amber, but what we have we'll show you as well, and all the information is available on our website at diodynamics.com. As you can see, even though these are pretty similar in size at first glance, there's some major differences when it comes to the size and form factor, the power level, and the beam pattern output of each one of these. Again, a major difference is the backlight feature, which provides that extra accent on the Diode Dynamics lights as well. You can find the Diode Dynamics product online at diodynamics.com or at a dealer near you. The Rigid and Baja options are available from major online retailers as well as directly through those websites. If you have questions, please leave them below. We'd love to hear them and help answer your questions to try to find the best option that meets your needs. Thanks for watching.